I'm gonna be honest, I've been like struggling with social media in general. Not just creating content, but with everything. People have just been so nasty. Hey guys, it's been quite a while. By the way, if you're new here, my name is Janet, aka J Aesthetics. If you are not following, what the hell are you waiting for? We'll click that subscribe button and let's get into it, guys. So the last time that I uploaded a video was 6 months ago. That's when I announced that I was gonna start competing and I was gonna start a prep vlog. Everything was kind of running smoothly till it really didn't. It's a little bit of a lot. I'm about to wrap my last show up. I've already competed 3 times. It's gonna be my 4th show. My 4th and last show in exactly 2 weeks. I'm a little sad that I had so many months of prep. And I like could have been making content, but I just couldn't get myself to do it. You know? I guess I just wasn't like mentally there, and it was like just so much else, so many other things that was like going on. I have to live like a regular person. I have to work. I have, you know, clients. I have like the challenges that I do. Then a boyfriend. Try to spend some time with my family. It's hard, you know. Like prepping is part of like my fitness journey, and it's something that I really love to do. As much as I would like to share, you know, sometimes like social media makes it just like hard to share because of all the negativity. I'm gonna be honest, I've been like struggling with social media in general, not just creating content, but with everything. People have just been so nasty. So I started like posting YouTube shorts, and I had to stop posting because the comments that I was getting here, like, I guess this is like incel mania. It was absolutely disgusting. Every single time I posted, it was just an entire negative experience for months. And I was like, you know what? Fuck that. So I stopped posting shorts, and it just kind of discouraged me from like posting videos to here. And it's not that I care what they feel about me. It's more like, I don't want that to ruin my experience with something that I really love to do. So I almost like I'm protecting that, you know? You know, it's here and it's in pictures, and I have pictures and I have footage and stuff, but it happens every time. It happens every prep. Why do people feel so entitled to just shut up, keep scrolling? I don't know. Something. Do something. Just get out of here and get out of my damn comments. I had the fever, I had a stomach virus, I have been sick, I almost quit. By the way, I've never ever almost quit. And I almost quit this time. I got a burn literally like a week before one of my shows. It's been hell of a ride. So the first month of my prep went astronomically smooth. Everything was going fantastic. My body was responding very well. 5 weeks into my prep, I started getting sick. I had a fever like 3 times in less than 3 weeks. I had H. pylori, I'm not sure, one of those two, which is a bacteria in your stomach. A lot of people actually have it, except they're asymptomatic. But of course, you know, that wouldn't happen to me. I was dealing with that for about 5 weeks. Remember, got fevers, chills, couldn't eat, defecating. It was horrible. Then I had to go on really heavy antibiotics for like 2 weeks. That happened for about 6 weeks. Then I had 5 weeks into my first national show. So my first national show was supposed to be Team Universe, which was July 4th weekend. A few weeks before that, I was like, you know what? I spent so much time dealing with this sickness. I wasn't mentally ready. I knew that I wouldn't be physically ready either. And I decided to do a later show, which was in Vegas. And we did a warm-up show in New York exactly a week before that. So I decided not to do Team U, which thankfully that happened because one of my cats, my first baby, really attached to my mom. Well, they were attached to each other, so I left her with my mom. The beginning of this year, she actually started to get really sick with kidney failure. I was going to my mother's house like a few times a week so that I can give her fluids, like subcutaneous fluids with a little needle. I learned how to do that until she just started getting sick at a very, very rapid speed. We knew that her time was like coming, but not like that soon. The doctor was really trying absolutely everything, the best treatment, the best meds, anything that we can possibly do to increase the quality of her life. But one day she was like really sick, so we rushed her to the vet, and unfortunately we went home without her. We had to leave her there. That was probably one of the most difficult decisions that I had to make. I was literally completely devastated. And that was actually the weekend that I was supposed to compete originally for Team U. Thankfully, we had pushed it. I had to put my cat down. And now I have about 3 weeks until next show in Vegas. So I did a warm-up show here, which I think I got like second place. I just did the show just to warm up. My body wasn't all the way completely ready. It was good that I went because I got the shakes off. I get super nervous on stage. You couldn't tell, but I'm like doing the Harlem Shake under here. And then the very next week, I did another show. So I did two peak weeks back to back. Never did that again. Never. It's just absolutely exhausting. Really an experience though. So I go to Vegas, fly over there. It was a 2-day show, Friday and Saturday. Literally booked my flight to come back home Saturday night. I was not expecting it to be a 2-day show. And that was the first time that I swear I ever felt that like super confident on stage. It was a blast. I loved it. I loved the experience. I wasn't expecting anything from it at all. So I didn't even place. I mean, I look great. I'm gonna show you a little video here.
You see, look at me. First time, no Harlem shaking up in here. Look at that swag. I mean, come on, come on.
Okay, so it didn't place, no call outs, no nothing. And I wasn't even upset about it. I understood why I didn't place. Every single division has a criteria and you have to meet it. Yes, I can look great. I can look shredded, but it's not about that. All right, there's certain things that you have to have. It will go over the criteria another time. I was completely fine with it. I was like, oh, I can enjoy some of my time here in Vegas. I'd never been. Went, I ate some food. I don't go crazy after my shows at all. I just can't. I also knew that this year I was going to be competing a few times. Coach actually lives in Vegas, so she was there and I got to like see her, got to like fix my posing. We have like a really, really great relationship. That's my girl. And that was the first time that we met like in person. So she was telling me, she was like, you know, I don't know if your body's gonna be ready for the next show, which was 5 weeks. I don't want to push your body like that. We're just gonna see what it wants to do. That's how we determine what shows we're gonna do, to seeing how my body recovers and reacts after a show. Let's give your body about a week and a half, see what it wants to do. You know, if it responds very well after every show, we increase the calories a bit, we scale back a little bit on the cardio, weight dropped. And she's like, oh shit, like maybe we could do the next show. Let's fucking go. And I'm like, fuck it, let's do it. We have 4 weeks until my next show in Pittsburgh. This is where it got interesting. The first time that I struggled so fucking hard. And I've struggled before. Prep is not always hard. It's not always challenging. It's not linear, right? It comes to a point where you gotta like dig. Your calories are going up, they're going down. It changes very, very often. My cardio, she cranked that shit up. 30 minutes of like Stairmaster. Then I had to run. I was doing running, all right? Me, run? I hate running. The worst thing ever. I was on fucking negative. So exhausted physically, mentally. Oh, had a chemical reaction to like this nail primer. Fell on my thigh. It was probably like this big on top of my thighs. Competing like in a, like a week and a half. I'm like, how does this happen to me? Those were the hardest 4 weeks of my entire prep, of this prep. And I was like, fuck this shit. Why am I even doing this? This is fucking stupid. I was thinking all of the most negative things about myself. And I'm not saying that I never ever get any negative thoughts about myself because I'm human. But I always stop myself. I'm like, don't do that. Let's not go there. I went there. So we're going to Pittsburgh. The Airbnb host cancels on us last minute. We get a place last minute, but the Airbnb host tells us that we don't have Wi-Fi or hot water for that night. We're like, you know what? We can do that for one night. The next day, the companies that are supposed to come, they don't. We have no heat. We have no water. We have no hot water. We have no Wi-Fi. And then I'm applying my tan. I'm packing everything up, competing the next day. Put my bag on top of the couch. Whole bottle of tanning solution. It fell on the couch. that doesn't belong to us. The entire bottle spilled. The couch was light gray suede. I was like, you know what? I'm over it. Next day comes, everything kind of like runs a little smoother, thankfully. Pittsburgh is a very, very big show. There was 19 bikini classes. It was incredible. Everyone looked the fuck good. So I get there and I don't place, but I get first call out, which is fucking huge. Just wasn't like enough for me. I shed a thug tear. It was a thug tear, y'all. It was, I cried. Anyway, my coach was like, this is not even you. You know, I'm gonna give it to you. You're tired, but like the way that you're talking, that's not you. This is not it. You know, if you want to call it and get into like an off season, my coach was like, you know, I would really love to see you on the amateur Olympia stage. You would look fucking crazy. I personally don't make decisions when I'm feeling like sad or anything. I know myself. I know I'm gonna get out of that mindset. I just have to get there first in order to make one of sound. So me and my coach get to talking and I tell her, I don't want to make any decisions based on like ego. If you feel like it's best for me to just take it off because, you know, that's it. Maybe I need some more growth. Maybe I need some more muscle. I don't know what the fuck they want. Like, I'm in a better headspace. So that's basically everything that happened over the last like 6 months. Now I'm 2 weeks out from the amateur O. That's crazy. I have a whole bunch of footage that I have been recording to make videos because I kind of want to show you guys at least the last 2 weeks. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, hit that subscribe button. Love you all. And till the next time. Goodbye.